I'm very pleased to award the Benefit Fund's Founder Award to the New York Post. Just so you know, we don't give the Founders Award out every year. We do it very infrequently, in fact. We give it out when we find an organization that's consistently portrayed the ideals and dedication to fallen New York City first responders and their families that really mirrors Rusty Staub's vision of the charity. Now, I'm sure that you really don't need to introduce the New York Post. Who here reads the Post? Exactly. I'm sure that you can find the New York Post in every police station, in every firehouse, in every patrol car, and in every EMS garage. It's everywhere. It's even on my iPhone. Why do we all read it? There are many choices. We read it because it's gritty, it's bold, it's New York City loudly opinionated, its front page tells the whole story, and it has great pictures. It portrays New York life like no other newspaper and no other medium in New York. It's read from here all the way up to the Bronx. It's been around for 215 years, and it's dutifully reported national and international news, but most importantly, it tells you what's really happening in our town. It reports on local fires, local crimes, big things, little things, emergencies on land and in the waters, around all five boroughs. In 1932, it reported the Ridge Tower fire at Park Avenue and 57th Street. In 1996, it reported the 23rd Street Wonder Drug fire that killed a dozen New York City firefighters. It reports the death of every police officer and firefighter killed in the line of duty, and it stays with that story long after it's gone from the headlines of other newspapers. It was there at 9/11. It was there in the aftermath at 9/11, and it still reports 9/11 cancer-related deaths while other papers have moved on. But most importantly, as far as we're concerned, the Post tells the story of New York City's finest and bravest in their everyday duties and their everyday chores. It has stories on each graduating class from the police and the fire academies. It humanizes the graduates. It has pictures of them with their proud parents and their children. It has stories on probies. It has stories on retiring officers. It has stories on the everyday acts of courage and selflessness in the face of danger that protect us all. All, of course, it also covers the police and the fire, football games, baseball games, and, of course, the famous hockey games. Pictures, box scores, and all. Each September 11th, the Post front page vividly shows the twin blue lights reaching skyward, and it regularly covers first responder-related memorial baseball games, street namings, and other events for our fallen heroes. Like our benefit fund, the Post remembers and never forgets. Like our benefit fund, it's been answering the call for over two centuries, portraying first responders as heroes for the ages. It's never been sidetracked by international or local politics of the day. And like our benefit fund, the Post will be there in the future, as will we. Because it's always understood the unique valor and personal sacrifice that our first responders effortlessly display, I'm very pleased to award the New York Police and Fire Widows and Children's Benefit Fund Founders Award to the New York Post. Here to accept the award is Jesse Angelo, the Chief Executive Officer and Publisher of the New York Post.
Jesse?
Thank you so much, Larry, and thank you to Answer the Call and everyone here for including us in this evening, and thank you very much for this award. I can tell you it was truly unexpected, and we are truly humbled. Very often when New York Post journalists go out and interview a first responder who's just done something heroic, some incredible act of bravery, we often hear the same thing. I was just doing my job. And very often when the time comes, unfortunately, and we're talking to a spouse whose loved one has made the ultimate sacrifice, or a family member who's lost a father or a sister or a brother, and they say the same thing. She was just doing her job. He was just doing his job. So all I can really say is our response to this award is we're just doing our job. We recognize and appreciate what you all do every day, putting your life on the line for this city. And we just want to make sure that the rest of the city and the rest of the world knows it too. Thank you.